Racing to the 2022 Breeders' Cup. This time, let's get an update and take a look at those speed figures as they get ready for the Breeders' Cup Dirt Mile on Tuesday. A major Future Stars Friday announcement. Blue Rose Sen, who would have been one of the top three favorites in the Juvenile Filly, she is out for the year. She will not be coming over for the Breeders' Cup. And Jackie's Warrior worked out a bullet on Tuesday. Of course, his final career race is going to be in the Breeders' Cup Sprint. Aloha West is back to defend his title in the Breeders' Cup Sprint. We're going to take a look at the speed figure progression of the Dirt Mile contenders, take a look at who's ran the fastest on the Brisnet pace figures and speed figures, and also kind of see if there's any days off patterns where somebody could be approaching a career top effort. And of course, basing these projections that Jack Christopher most likely, according to trainer Chad Brown, is going to be running in the sprint. He is going to be pre-entered for the mile and the sprint. And Cyberknife is also going to be on the cutback running here in the Dirt Mile. Grade one races from 10 furlongs in the Travers to the Dirt Mile, and he'll be facing older horses. Now, the Dirt Mile looks like it's going to be about a 10-horse field. You're going to get Slow Down Andy, a stakes winner. Cyberknife, of course, he won the Haskell Stakes and the Arkansas Derby. Senior Buscador, a winner at Churchill Downs. Gunite, possibly. Laurel River, Three Techniques, Simplification, and Law Professor. A big effort the last time out as he took on Life is Good. Let's take a look at the speed figures from the Brisnet scale as we get ready for the Dirt Mile. Now, again, we have the horse's name on the left-hand side. Then the starts go from left to right. So the first career start is all the way to the left, and then the most recent start, if they have up to 10 starts, is on the right-hand side. So Slow Down Andy has only ran 9 career races. His most recent speed figure is a 100. Meanwhile, Laurel River, he's only ran 7 career races. His most recent speed figure is a 108. That is a career top, and it is the best in the race. Meanwhile, a 105 for Cyberknife. And then when you look at a horse like Cody's Wish, he's reeled off a 106, a 104, and a 105. He beat Jackie's Warrior the last time. He definitely fits on speed figures. And when you look at Cyberknife, he's reeled off a 104, a 105, and a 105, but he's did that against 3-year-olds, and the last time out was a 10 furlong race. Before that, he ran 9 furlongs in the Haskell. Now, speed figures are distance adjusted and track adjusted. So the way you're supposed to look at speed figures is that 105 from Cyberknife is the same as a 105 from Cody's Wish. But that's kind of the art of handicapping, because we know that Cody's Wish did it at 7 furlong. Cyberknife did it at 10 furlongs. Cody's Wish did it in a small field, and he did it facing Jackie's Warrior, and Cyberknife did it with slower fractions going longer. So that's where you may want to adjust some of these speed figures. The only speed figures that really adjust for pace is Timeform US. And Bayer doesn't adjust for pace. They don't adjust for ground loss. So that's where sometimes I like to mark a horse up. I think they can improve, or down if I don't think they can improve. Now, on the other hand, when you take a look at some of the different Breeders' Cup rest that they're going to be coming into this race, you've got Cody's Wish coming in off a 70 days rest, Laurel River off a 70 days rest, Simplification off 42. He'll be cutting back in distance. Slow Down Andy on 35 days rest. So they're going to be fitting some good patterns. Gunite ran last week, so he's going to be coming on a 2-week turnaround. And then Cyberknife, a 42 day rest, coming back off that Travers Stakes the last time out. They're going to have to try to sharpen up his speed. Most likely he comes off the pace. Some of the notes about this race: you've got Cody's Wish, 5 for 5 at a mile. Very impressive. Of course, last time out came off the pace, won the Forego Stakes. He won the Westchester Stakes at Belmont. That one, he chased some 108 and 4 fractions in the one-turn mile. And then at Churchill Downs, he does have a win by 2 lengths and by 5 lengths. So 6 for 10 lifetime, 5 for 5 at a mile for Cody's Wish for Godolphin Blue. Now, Cyberknife, you know, I think he's going to be a presser at 1 mile. He's been running those longer races, a mile and a 16th, a mile and an eighth, a mile and a quarter. He's going to cut back. But when you notice his one sprint race as a two-year-old in November, he came off the pace in a 6.5 furlong race. I think Cyberknife by Gunrunner coming off the pace definitely fits the mold of a potential horse that could run well in the dirt mile. And then Senior Buscador, he's an off-pace closer, chased down the speed the last time in the ACAC. That was at Churchill Downs. He fits the distance profile. He's an older horse, got a nice pedigree for the 1 mile to a mile and eighth distance. And class-wise, he ran in the Pat O'Brien, he ran in the San Diego, he ran in the last year, ran in a couple of preps for the Triple Crown, Risen Star, Springboard Mile, so he has some back class, and I think he is going to be strong at the 1 mile distance. Now the recap, Cody's Wish comes off a career top effort. Laurel River, powerful 7 furlong effort, going to be coming off a little bit of a layoff. And then Cyberknife, grade one class, he cuts back to a mile, but he's got to face older horses off a little bit of a layoff. Don't forget, on the channel, we got to look at the classic speed figures on October 17th, juvenile speed figures on October 18th, and the distaff speed on October 19th. Who do you like in the dirt mile? Leave some of your comments. Do you think Cyberknife will like the cutback? What about Cody's Wish? People are overlooking him. 5 for 5 at 1 mile as we get you ready for the Breeders' Cup 2022.